Daniel Whittle once said, "I hope that I will never write a hymn that does not contain a message. There are too many hymns that are just a meaningless jingle of words. In order to do good, a hymn must be founded on God's word and carry the message of God's love." Born in Massachusetts in 1840, Daniel Webster Whittle was named after Daniel Webster, who was a bold and fearless Christian leader in the cause of freedom. Webster once declared, "God grants liberty only to those who love it and are always ready to guard and defend it." It was the prayer of Whittle's parents that he too would be a bold and fearless Christian. Unfortunately, as a teenager and a young man, this was not the case. At the age of 21, Daniel Whittle joined the army. Just before leaving home, his dear mother had given him a copy of the New Testament. In the words of Whittle, "She followed me with many a prayer." He served honorably throughout the war, acquiring, at the end, the rank of major. He faced many challenges throughout: separation from his wife, and a wound that led to the loss of his right arm. While recovering from his amputation, he longed for something to read. After looking through his backpack, he found that little New Testament his mother had given him, and he began to read it. He could not put it down. Matthew, Mark, Luke, all the way to Revelation, he read it through and then immediately started again. Even after reading it for days, he still had no thoughts of trusting Christ as his Savior. Until one night, he was awakened by the nurse at the hospital, and she asked, "Will you please go pray for this boy at the other end of the ward? He is dying." He said to the nurse, "I cannot pray for him. I am a wicked man." She replied, "I always see you reading your Bible. I thought you were a praying man. Won't you still come anyways and please pray with him? I have no one else to ask." As Whittle approached the bedside of the young man no older than 18, the boy explained he was afraid of dying and needed someone to pray with. Overwhelmed by the reality of death, Daniel Whittle fell to his knees and prayed not just for this boy, but that God would save him from his sins. When he finished praying, the boy was dead. But there was a look of peace upon his face. This was the day Daniel Whittle's attention was turned to the Lord Jesus Christ. Now known as Major Whittle, he left his secular job and he became one of the best friends of the famous Dwight L. Moody. He spent his years in evangelistic ministry with P.P. Bliss, who would sing the songs he wrote, like Almost Persuaded. After writing There Shall Be Showers of Blessing and There Is a Royal Banner, Moody said he had written some of the best hymns of the century. Perhaps the greatest testimony was, "I know not why God's wondrous grace to me he hath made known, nor why unworthy Christ in love redeemed me for his own. But I know whom I have believed." These are the words that describe the Christian testimony